Going. We're going to Carl's Jr. to get some lunch. That's it. We're just going to stop there. Turn around, go home. So we're headed to... you guys. The four of us are headed to this campsite just off the Columbia River. 2 hours roughly east of Portland. I saw this place online. I said I want to spend Father's Day there with my kids, and so I forced you girls and James to come with me. And you guys are happy about that, aren't you?
Yeah.
I know Lily's thrilled. And we're gonna be there for the next few days. I got several things fixed on the motorhome since we last went anywhere. I got the door fixed, so it just opens and closes really well by itself. And I got the refrigerator fixed, so now it works off the propane. So we don't have to run the generator as long as we normally do. And we don't have to run the DC batteries down to nothing, which is good for the batteries. But I digress. And that's where we're headed right now. Except we're stuck in this gnarly traffic that is adding about 20 minutes to our time. Once we get on the freeway, it's entirely freeway because it's right off Interstate I-84. You just head I-84 east like you're going to Idaho and you'll bump into it. It's that simple.
Awesome.
Maybe we'll accidentally not go there and go to Idaho.
Supposedly, no. That's like a 10-hour drive.
Well, I'm up for it.
No, I'm not.
Maybe next time. I'd like to go to Idaho this summer.
That'd be cool.
That would be cool. I've never been. He's pounding down, loaded up and trucking. Are we gonna do what they say can't be done? We've got a long way to go and a short time. Interstate 84 runs from downtown Portland all the way to Idaho. There's a lot to see and do along this stretch of freeway, and believe it or not, this is the farthest east I've personally been in Oregon. Try not to fill up your gas tank after you leave Portland until you get to the Dalles. All the gas stations in between are in the middle of nowhere, and believe me, you pay for it. Once you take the exit, you turn left towards the river. You're going to end up taking the last left when you get down to the very end. If you were to actually turn right, you would find other camping and day use areas, but there's nothing there with water access. But the views are pretty. Once we're off the freeway, it's just a hop, skip, and a jump to the spot. And we find a nice little spot next to the river.
We have arrived. down. It's really steep. Whoa. Oh, I put sunscreen on. I should have put sunscreen on. Yeah, that was a good idea if I did. I'll be okay. I'm gonna swim in that little. Don't wanna get my sheets wet. It's warm. It's a lot more warmer than I thought it was gonna be.
I can't see anything. That's the funny thing.
I set up camp while Rose continuously records our surroundings. James is completely thrilled. Lily plays with the RC car that I got for my birthday. It doesn't have much power over the rocky camp area. Our camp area is owned by the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers and monitored by the Oregon Parks Department. I saw a park ranger at least once a day the entire time we were there, as well as the county sheriff. Oh my God, it's like really steep. Well, I only brought three chairs from the looks of it. Oh, this isn't bad. I don't know how it is to get back up again, but.
Okay, no water.
How is it?
It's actually pretty cold, but you get used to it fast.
Oh, why do you have your purse? What's in it?
Nintendo. No! Soft. Ah! Stop it! Seriously, stop! No, stop, my back's getting wet. Stop. Seriously, I mean it.
Are you cooler now? The Columbia River offers some fantastic views, and it separates the state of Oregon from the state of Washington. Another thing to note is that whatever the weather is doing in Portland, it's worse here. If it's hot in Portland, it's hotter here. In the wintertime, chains for your vehicle are required, and this area is just a giant sheet of ice and snow. Eventually, kids will be kids, but Rose is enjoying her time in the sun. I decided to take some still photos and record a TikTok because, well, why not? We eventually decide to take a walk to check out our surroundings. We end up across the way a bit to a little day use area. No camping is allowed over here, but fishing and water usage is. Be sure to bring good walking shoes, as walking on these rocks is not easy in sandals. We walk over to the free pit toilets that are available. Now, I made the mistake of opening the door to one, and let me tell you, the smell hit me like a ton of you know what. Yeah, don't use these unless you have to. The rest of the day, we just sort of relaxed around camp. There were these birds watching us, I think, hoping we would drop some food. I eventually just threw bread at them and kind of watched them fight it out. And as the sun is setting and our day is ending, we sit down at the table to do battle.
I shall destroy them in Udo! Oh, 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 oh. There is an old Uno saying.
No, there isn't.
Today is a good day to die.
Nothing but draw fours. Nothing but draw fours. This is a complete travesty.
I am destroying him.
Oh, it's my turn. Oh, nice draw two you got there. Thank God you reversed it. What is that, a three?
That's the only good card I have.
Yeah. All right, play it now. All right, Lily. Go again.
I thought it was on Rose.
No, it's on me.
Oh. Wow, you tried to get me. Okay. Can we do points?
No.
Well, now that you win.
Well, just for that, you get to shuffle.
As it gets darker, the night fishermen come out. They got them some massive nets, too.
We're just waking up. Interesting night. During the night, the boats, the fishermen boats, the fish boats, are literally going by, and they've got their lights that shines into your, unintentionally of course, into your RV. So you really need to be prepared to have a bunch of lights that you're not used to seeing in your RV. So be prepared for that. The other thing is the amount of trains that go by. So you got the trains over there on the Washington side. But over here on the Oregon side, there's a bunch of trains that go by as well. So you kind of wake up to the sound of that. Other than that, you are kind of next to the freeway, which is behind me. I didn't really notice much of that once I closed the door. So that wasn't that huge of a deal. It's mostly the trains and the lights from the boats. Mainly because we just weren't used to them. And if we were used to them, it wouldn't be an issue. But we are perfectly fine. It's really hot today. It's going to be 94 Fahrenheit. And we're going to spend a lot of time in the water, I have a feeling. And then I'm going to do some fishing. Hopefully this wind will shut down so I can fly the drone. But we're all just kind of waking up right now. I'm going to have some breakfast. We're gonna have some fun. It's gonna be a hot one. On Sunday when we go home, it's gonna be 98 degrees. It's gonna be a record high. That's the forecast. And I'm not particularly happy about it. But I will cross that bridge when we come to it. All right, time for some breakfast.
After breakfast, I decide to get my fishing gear out, and of course, I don't catch a thing. I really hope that my neighbor has a little better luck than I do. And the search and rescue team decides to run themselves a few drills in the area, and I decide to actually put something that I put together, give it a little test. I actually take about 5 gallons of water out of the Columbia River, and I'm going to try and filter it for drinking water. Add a wee bit of bleach to kill any bacteria or viruses. Stir it around and let it sit for about 15-20 minutes or so. Now, off to something else.
Okay, everyone, we're going to try this again. Just like in my last video, I mentioned this had a magnet on it. It's got a really powerful magnet. You really got to pull it to get it off. one of my subscribers suggested that I take this and put it on the hood of the car. Said it might actually make the signal go farther. So we're gonna give it a try. We're on, I don't know if you can really see it. I don't know if you can see that really well. We're on channel 19. We're gonna give this a try. We're right next to all this freeway. So in theory, I should be getting a signal 5 miles in any direction. All right, in theory. So we're gonna give this a try. Testing, testing, 1, 2, 3. Testing, testing, 1, 2, 3. Can anybody hear me? I am testing my new CB radio. If you can hear me, please respond. Thank you. All right, so we'll give that a try. See if anybody responds to me. Yeah, we just spent some time making breakfast, and it's getting to be almost lunchtime, actually. It's amazing how quickly the time goes by. This was the location I was really hoping we'd get a signal of some kind, just because we're right next to the freeway. So I'm going to try this again. Testing, testing, 1, 2, 3. Testing, testing, 1, 2, 3. I am testing my new CB radio. If you can hear this, please respond. Over. Thank you. I'm very inexperienced when it comes to CB radios, and you could probably tell. Doesn't look like we're getting a strong response. Test, test, test. Can anyone hear me? Test, test, test. I will switch it over to a different channel if I don't get anything in the next 30 seconds or so. There's just nothing but semis going by. I guess semis don't have a lot of CB radios anymore. Maybe it's a days gone by kind of thing. All right, we're gonna go back down to channel 10. I don't know if you can see that. Can you see that? It's channel 10. It's hard to see the video camera screen in the sunlight. We're gonna try this again. Testing, testing, 1, 2, 3. Testing, testing, 1, 2, 3. I am testing my CB radio. Can anybody hear me? Over. And since our last video, I've actually purchased another CB radio at a secondhand shop that's designed to go in the actual RV itself. Unfortunately, I don't seem to have the proper plug-in for to power it. So I'm gonna have to figure out something, because I'd love to hook that thing up and see if we can play with it while we're driving. Okay, we're gonna give it one more try. Testing, testing, 1, 2, 3. Testing, testing, 1, 2, 3. Can anybody hear me? I'm testing my new CB radio. Can anyone hear me? Please respond, over. We're on a very busy freeway, Interstate 84. So in theory, we should be getting something. Channel 9, that takes you to an emergency channel. That's supposed to be an emergency. But I'm gonna give it a try anyway. See if anybody's here to listen to me. Testing, testing, 1, 2, 3. Testing, I'm testing my CB radio. Please respond if anyone can hear me. Over. And we'll give it about 30 seconds and we'll just give it a 30 seconds and call it good. At least for today, maybe try it again tomorrow. That's too bad. I'd like to see if this thing works or not. I don't know if it works if nobody's responding to me. So unless I find another one and I get my daughters to, help me test it, then I'm pretty much out of luck. Oh well, next time.
There are no signs limiting the amount of time you can spend here. One could literally spend the whole summer in one spot, provided you follow the rules, of course. Unlike some places I have camped at, this spot in the gorge is very clean, and everyone around me were quiet at night when we were trying to sleep, making this my new favorite camping spot. One day here, and I know I'll be back next year, if not before the end of the summer.
This is a contraption of my own design, kind of inspired by what I was seeing on the interwebs. So what you do is you take the water that I got from the Columbia, I added a cap full of bleach, and that sanitizes it. Okay, so you don't need a lot, you just need a little bit, and then you gotta kind of stir it around, and then you just let it sit for a little bit. You add the water to this top bucket. The water pressure comes through here. I got this filter at a Goodwill. I found three of them. I put one under my sink at home. So now we've got filtered water. And then it'll come through here and it'll filter out everything, including the bleach. It's not quick, it's not fast, because it's literally using the weight of the water to push it through. We're gonna test this in a real world scenario. Here's a park ranger. I've tested it at home using dirty water, literally water from the shower that I added dirt to and basically created almost a thin mud, and it worked just fine. So we're going to test this in a real world scenario. I've been wanting to do this for a while. So you just put it in here, and the weight of the water puts it through here, filters it, and puts it in there. It's not a fast way of getting water, but it'll take about an hour, but you'll have clean drinking water. So here we go. ...40 pounds of water. All right, so there were some... sizable algae or something in there, so I went ahead and just threw the bottom part out because that's the heaviest that stayed. You can still see a little bit in there, but it'll filter it out. You can see some impurities in there, but the filter will take care of it. So I'm gonna go get some more water, and so we'll have 5 gallons of drinkable water here in about 3 or 4 hours. It'll be enough to last us this weekend. So I went and put more water here, put a little bit more bleach in it. We're gonna let that sit for about 15 minutes. In the meantime, what's happening is the water's exiting there through that, going through there, and it's filling the filter. And the pressure of the water will eventually push it out there into this bucket where I put a spigot right there. And so, like I said, it'll take a while. Ultimately, I'll add the bucket in between the two, which will actually help with the gravity and the pressure and all that, but you'll see that shortly. So this was the bucket that I went to the river and got the water. I poured it all in here. So it's filled up to here with the water that's had the bleach in it. Then I put it in the middle so that gravity can help do its thing.
While the water is filtering, we decide to take a walk. The temperature is approaching 100 degrees, and Lily never takes her hoodie off. I swear I was sweating more and more every time I looked at her. I know what people are probably thinking, but believe me, everyone had fresh sunscreen on every single day. The walk isn't easy over these rocks. Next time, I'm going to bring my walking shoes with me. And eventually, Rose catches up with us. As we're walking, we find this wonderful pond, and as I'm walking by the pond, I see 3 really big fish in there, and you know what I'm thinking.
As always, my goal is to catch a fish before your mother catches a fish. We kind of have a gentleman's bet over it. The key thing is for this old man to get down there into the water with my phone in my pocket.
Your phone's at the OV.
Huh?
Never mind.
My phone's right here.
I thought you forgot it.
No, I'm gonna leave my phone here. But I'll take the bait and I'll take the net because I'm gonna catch the biggest fish in this thing.
Right? What if you don't?
Yeah, and we're gonna have it for dinner. Isn't that right, Rose?
Okay, I don't eat meat.
That's my vegetarian daughter talking. All right, here we go. Wish me luck. If I fall and break my neck, Rose, you have to help me up. That's your job as the daughter. I give you life.
What?
Save mine. All right, here we go. And the fish left.
Because they got scared of you.
Here we go. We're going to give this a try from this distance, okay?
Okay.
Marshmallows are literally made of sugar and the water dissolves them. Everybody swears by those marshmallows. I swear. They've never done anything for me.
Yeah.
And then Rose gets bored of videotaping me not catching a fish, so she goes off and plays with the camera.
The Columbia River!
Eventually, even I get tired of not catching a fish, so I decide to try it on this side of the Columbia River.
So Rose and I didn't catch any fish, and she and I came back, still in Oregon, because Washington State is where Oregonians go to bury bodies.
Slowly but surely, my water filtration system is, well, filtering water. It's going a little slower than I was hoping. After a short while, some paragliders, or is it parasailing? I can never remember. Decide to show up on the Columbia River. They are more athletic in one afternoon than I've been in my entire life. I threw my back out watching this guy. And there goes my hip.
So I'm going to be brief. So I realized eyeballing the amount of water that we had, drinkable water that is, bottled water, that we were a little low. So I walked into town. Yes, that's right. I walked into town. It was about an hour to get there. It's 90 degrees Fahrenheit outside and I'm a big fat guy. So I sweated and puffed and puffed and puffed and huffed and I got there. And I blew the house down. So I grabbed as much water as I could carry and a big old bag of ice on my shoulder. The ice kept me cool on the way home. I got about an eighth of the way home and some nice guy in a Ford F-150 stopped and said, hey, hop in the back, I'll drive you there. I said, thank you. So I came back and here we are. The swamp cooler, I put the ice in the swamp cooler. The swamp cooler was pretty useless. And a swamp cooler is one of those, I don't know what you call it. The swamp cooler is one of those coolers that you drill the holes in and you put the ice in and you put the fan and you kind of let it cool up the area. Yeah, it was pretty useless. It didn't really cool anything down. So I'm gonna chuck that thing. And I think I'm honestly going to put an air conditioner where the microwave is in this thing. I think I'm just gonna pull out that microwave. That microwave oven is 1,000 years old. and it doesn't heat things up very well, and it uses a lot of power. You can hear the generator just push to use it, and it wouldn't let you use the fan, the microwave, and the TV at the same time. Of course, the fan got ripped up off the top of the roof. That's a whole different story I'll tell you about some other time. Happy birthday to me, it was. So that's what's going on. It's really warm, but the wind has shifted. There are a lot of parasailers and paragliders and people like that out on the river. And, oh, there's one popping up right now. And I'm just sort of enjoying the time that I have left, which will be what's left today and tomorrow. Let's get a shot of this dude in the para something or other. He's paragliding. Let's get a shot of the paragliding dude. With that said, my water filtration system is not working the way I originally thought it would. It's not working as quickly. There's also become a bit of a leak, which I will have to repair. The other thing is the water doesn't taste that good. Of course, it came from the Columbia, so who knows? I'm going to empty it out and try it with the water that I have in the backyard. I think it's perfectly healthy. It just tastes weird. I don't think it would hurt us. I think it's just something we're not used to tasting. You get a certain use to tasting bottled water, and then all of a sudden you're tasting something else completely. It just kind of tastes odd, you know what I mean? I ended up getting a wee bit adventurous, and I climbed the giant rock pile that was right next to us. Everybody else was doing it, so what the heck. I brought the camera, and I was able to get a little better view of our campground. She's sliding down the hill.
Oh, ow.
Get up and walk.
What am I?
Yeah, and? I'll have it on videotape and we'll laugh about it.
No.
What are you doing?
Come in.
I can't reach you. Oh, Jesus. All right. I'm gonna get a video of both of us falling down the damn hill. Oh, here we go. We decide to take a walk, and I'll tell you, in this hot weather, this cold water feels really good. After you spend some time walking, you put your feet in the water, and it cools you right down. And then at nighttime, there's a nice cool breeze that comes through. Well, the sun is setting, and we are ending yet another day here in our Columbia River Gorge. And it's time once again for the children to be destroyed.
Attitude.
On the last day of school, we were sitting in biology, right? And
ew.
This kid gets a spam call and he puts it on speaker.
No way!
And he's like, watch, it's gonna be about my car's extended warranty.
No way! And he's how old?
And he's like 16.
Oh, okay. You can technically own a car.
And so it is. And then later that day during lunch, I get that same exact message from the same exact person. It's amazing.
All right, so today is our last full day here at the Columbia River Gorge. We leave tomorrow. Tomorrow's Father's Day, 2021. And today's our last day of chill. It was really windy last night. You know, I'm kind of surprised this place isn't busier than it is. I mean, it's free and it's perfect. Either way, we have nothing on our agenda but to sit around and literally stare at each other. And then tomorrow we have to go home. I have a client on Monday I have to pick up from the airport. And there we go. And that's that. So, today is just relaxing and fooling around.
And here we are. It's our last full day here. I tried to fly my drone today. This thing, you may remember this thing from a previous review that you can see on this channel. And the review is literally just there. I'll let you do a search of it and let you take a look at what I think of this. Those of you who remember this may recall that I actually was having issues with this because one of the propellers was spinning even when it was powered off. So real long of it short, it took me a while to get a hold of Holy Stone. I was calling them Holy Stone for some reason. Holy Stone is the maker of the HS110D. That's the maker of this thing. And they got a hold of it and they said, okay, can you show us a video of what it's doing or not doing? So I sent them a link to my YouTube video, which if you haven't seen it, just do a search of it. It's in my channel. And I showed it to them and told them what I thought of it. And they said, you know what? We're gonna send you a replacement. So to Holy Stone's credit, they sent me a brand new, modeled, non-refurbished, brand spanking new model Holy Stone drone. And I thought, well, that's pretty cool, especially since they didn't require I send the old one back. So what I had was a broken drone, but I also had a bunch of extra parts, which is kind of nice because this thing comes with two batteries, a brand new one, which meant that, you know, when they sent me the second one, that means I got four batteries, which is really cool. So to update you on what's going on with this thing, I still can't fly it. Well, you know, I technically could fly it. What I can't do is use the camera. The camera, for whatever reason, it communicates with your phone wirelessly, and then it records images and, of course, pictures and whatnot. That's pretty basic as far as drones are concerned. The software now crashes my phone. I'm not joking. It was working just fine. When I was camping and the other one broke on me and I couldn't get it to, the propeller was just moving. It just wanted to move all the time. The app was working fine. Now it crashes my phone. My phone isn't the fanciest phone out there. I'm not one who lives and dies by the newest, bestest, brightest iPhone you can get, because that's just, I'm not so childish. Mine's a basic run-of-the-mill Android. No frills, no thrills. It's not the newest one on the market, and it certainly isn't the lowest end you can get. It's pretty much right smack dab in the middle. It's functional. It suits me fine. I don't have any problems with any apps except for Holy Stone. So as I've told the stories before, this is the fourth drone that I've owned. The first one broke. The second one got stuck in a tree where I was going to just let it come down naturally, but someone trimmed the tree and I lost the drone. And then the third one, well, you know the story of the third one. And this is the fourth. I don't doubt that this drone works. This drone, I'm sure, works fantastic. But I have no way of knowing it, because without the camera working, I'm not good enough of a drone pilot to be able to fly a drone without the camera working. Certain things in the universe have to align in order for me to be good enough to fly a drone. Not too much wind, you gotta have enough daylight, and you gotta have the camera working so I can see the point of view of the drone and how I can fly it around and turn it around and all that. So unfortunately,
I am going to have to say that this particular item is still a pass for me. I would not purchase this drone again if I had my druthers. I'm probably going to end up selling this drone along with the spare parts and all that to someone else on the Craigslist. I don't know. Whichever. Just to get it out of my hair. Just so I don't have to deal with it anymore. And then I'll think, well, you know, maybe for Christmas, Santa Claus will bring me something that I can actually work with. So, unfortunately, I'm in a campground, which would be perfect for a drone, because it's all open space. There's zero trees in the way. This place would be perfect. Unfortunately, it's not really conducive to the fact that it keeps crashing my phone. So, Hollystone HS Series HS110D is still an avoid for me. Someday I'll get a drone that's good for someone, a novice like myself, who wants to take high definition video of his campsites just to make his videos look nicer. Look at me, I can waste my money on stuff I don't need. I'm so rich. You can sort of see the sun setting behind me, huh? I'll see if I can get a little better sunlight on my face. There we go. Here we are. It's our last night. It's almost bedtime. It's about, what, 9:45, I think? Our last night. Tomorrow morning, we gotta leave. And here we are. I don't want to go. We have enough food, and we have enough water to last another day or two. And I'd love to stay, but I'm out of focus. And I'd love to stay, but I got a client I got to work with tomorrow. There's a train across the river on the Washington side. I got a client on Monday, and I have to go back to life. And it's times like this that make me wish that I was a full-time RVer. I mean, my gosh, the moon by itself and the autofocus is going nuts. I don't know if you can even see my face. There we go. That's a little better. Maybe you shouldn't see my face focused. But seriously, we gotta get home. We gotta see Jashawn. We gotta get everything. Gotta go back to life. I wish this was my life. Someday, it's almost bedtime, so I suppose I should be getting going. See you tomorrow. West. Are we gonna do what they say can't be done? We've got a long way to go and a short time to get there. I'm West. I'm just watch your bandit run.
Green Douglas fir where the waters cut through. Down our wild mountains and canyons she flew. Canadian Northwest to the ocean so blue. It's roll on, Columbia, roll on. Roll. Columbia, roll on. Your power is turning our darkness to dawn. Roll on, Columbia.